the guy, man, I haven't seen you talk about it. I want to see you scout him at some point. Asante Samuel Jr. Everyone's been talking about him. The FSU kid. Come on, man.
Ooh,
he's like, he's the son of Asante Samuel, of course. But
I see people in the waiting room being like, yeah, that's my guy. That's who I'm trying to talk about. Lee, you're next. Wait up.
No, and everyone, like, in all your stuff, when you're talking about the corners of Croc, everyone was like, Asante Samuel Jr., Asante Samuel Jr.
So that's the guy that's, like, that Niner fans are hoping for at 43, is what you're saying?
Yeah, but I think he could probably –
5'11"?
Yeah, he's 5'11".
That's not too small. I'm just saying, I thought the Niners are looking for a big dude.
Yeah, and I agree with that, quite frankly. But I also think
– if he's good, he's good. That's the thing. If he's good, he's good. Fair enough. Yeah, you don't want to be looking for a type. You want to be looking for a guy who's not going to be terrible.
Exactly. He's fast. He's good in space. Caleb like
Witherspoon's big, but it didn't work out. So, yeah.
Exactly. You just need to get good players.
All right. So, look, I promise you I will do a little Asante Samuel breakdown. Yeah, yeah. It's a good call. I should have done that already. Thank you. For sure.
Yeah.
What do you think of him real quick before I let you go?
So, a little undersized. I would want to see him. Small. No, but he's just undersized. Yeah. I mean, just not prototypical, but his speed is great. I think he makes up for it in what I really love, and I think you said this before with corners, what you want to see is that open field space that, you know, when they need to make a play, what happens? You're going to love him in terms of that. So,
okay.
Listen, he's probably going to be a top 25, top 35 pick, but he could be one of those guys that if he's there.
Well, I see on CBS they rank him in the 40s, so it's someone we definitely need to consider, and the Niners need to consider. All right, I'll do my homework. Thank you, Ben. I appreciate it.
Hey, and hey, good luck for the draft, Grant. It'll be busy. I know if you see my little name, we're both pros. I understand what you're going.
I bought this like a month ago when UCLA was running through the it finally came. So
I gotta say your boy Johnny Juzang, he announced for the draft.
Oh, I hate that about college basketball.
But
and he should go though. He's a good player.
NBA is awesome, man. Come on.
Yeah, you probably do that. Yeah. All right, man. Good to see you, man.
Good talking to you, Grant.
Been talking to you too. Johnny Juzang, man. As soon as I learned the guy's name, he's gone from my school. That's all right. Oh well. What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do about it? Lee. Let's talk about
Asante Samuel.
Yeah, what's up,
man? Yeah, I'm a big fan of his. I just wanted to touch on the same things that actually Ben was talking about, and that's I'll just quickly go through the quarterbacks and then move on to day two and day three picks where I think Kyle should attack. Obviously I think it's gonna be either Trey Lance or Fields. You know, I'm a Fields guy. I just feel like I said, you know, Trey Lance, to me, that's a project and it's sort of going to hold us back. I feel like we need to win now, this year coming, or the following season. I feel like, you know, we've got too many guys that are going to roll over and we're going to lose with these one-year contracts and you're sort of rebuilding. So, yeah, that's the reason I feel Fields over Lance. And when I look at Mac Jones, he's like the Prius. He's a Prius. You know, he gets you from A to B, gets the job done, but nothing special. Trey Lance is like the Hummer, you know. He's like a modern Hummer. He's got all the gadgets. He can do a lot of things, but he doesn't have accuracy and he doesn't handle the road that well. You know what I mean? He can lose traction and go off the road.
Absolutely.
And then you look at a guy like Justin Fields.
He's almost better off the road than on the road.
Exactly.
Yes.
Yeah, and that's him running the ball sometimes, you know, and making extending plays.
Yes.
And then I look at a guy like Justin Fields, and to me, he's the Bugatti. He's got speed. Okay. He's got power. He's got precision accuracy, you know.
Yeah.
He can handle the roads. He can win you the Indy 500, and that's all we need at quarterback. So rolling over to day two, day three, Kyle, this is where I want to help you out. If you do mess up on this quarterback, you need to go out there and get Asante Samuel Jr. if he falls. I think that's the best defensive pick. And I feel like on offense, and the reason is he's got good hips, good backpedal. He plays like he's just like a missile, like coming after defenders. Like he plays recklessly. He has no care for his body. Not in terms of putting himself in bad position, but he's a dog. Like, he'll play, he'll give you everything he's got every weekend. And I feel like that's the guy you need to go for. You've seen his dad. He had a good career. You know, he had a great career. And I feel like he's even more physical than his dad. He's also good against the run. And I feel like that's a good pick. If he falls out of the end of that first round into the second, if he's not there, a guy like Elijah Moore, I think, is another good pick out of Ole Miss.
Okay.
He's a guy that, if you go look at it, what he did in the last season, he had like double-digit receptions every single game except for Auburn game, and he had over 100 yards pretty much every game except for that game. And he's just a guy that's going to give you a lot of receptions. I feel like he's a huge upgrade over a guy like Kendrick Bourne Grant. Kendrick was he wasn't an elite receiver, but he did a lot of work for us. You know, he did a lot of the hard stuff. He got us a lot of yards and receptions. And this
first
guy's
down.
Got
yep.
Yeah, and this guy can do that and more. He's got 4.3 speed, great hands, great route running. He reminds me a lot of Antonio Brown when I first watched them. Like, that's the kind of guy that I think
that's the comp he gets on it on his NFL.com draft profile too. I've seen that. Yeah.
Yeah, and that's what I see when I first watched it. And then now I've seen guys compare him to AB, and I'm like, that's exactly what I see when I first looked at him. And I do a lot of research over the draft time, and I've been really right on a lot of picks. Like, my worst pick in the first round the last 4 years, Grant, has been a back-to-back Pro Bowler. And I hit 6th-rounders, 5th-rounders, Terry McLaurin, guys like Antonio Gibson in the third round.
I love Terry McLaurin. Yeah.
So don't mess this up, Kyle. Go after the best player available. In the third round, I'll give you two other options. I'm going to give you a guy out of USC, Amon Ra. If Elijah Moore's not there, get Amon Ra. He can do exactly the same things that he can do, similar. Not quite as fast, but he's strong. But
yeah. Yep.
Better than Kendrick Bourne, way more potential. And the other guy is the last cornerback that could fall into the third round. Is you might have to move up for him in the third round, but go after Tyson Campbell out of Georgia. He's perfect for our scheme, cover three, loose hips, agility, fast, and they produce some real good DBs out of Georgia. He's the guy for our fit, our scheme.
You just gave Kyle and John a whole lot of information. They're very appreciative. Thanks a lot, man. Use your homework.
No worries, Greg.